El Shaddai, bless you guys. I am Archangel. Jesus Christ is Lord. Jesus Christ is come in the flesh. This is an intro to my channel and my commitment, my personal commitment to you. Okay? What is deliverance? In Matthew 16, start in verse 18, "And I say also unto thee that thou art Peter, and upon this rock I will build my church, and the gates of hell shall not prevail against it." Okay, so when is the last time that gates attack people? The gates of hell will not prevail against it. That means that we are going against the gates of hell. We are attacking hell. And hell's gates cannot prevail against us, meaning we are overcoming hell, going into hell, and bringing people out and taking back our ground. The next verse, "And I will give unto thee the keys of the kingdom of heaven, and whatsoever thou shalt bind on earth shall be bound in heaven, and whatsoever thou shalt loose on earth shall be loosed in heaven." So when you pray for God to deliver you, that is a prayer that is not rooted in truth. Jesus Christ gave us the keys to the kingdom, to bind and to loose. That's why when you don't pray, "Lord, help me to forgive such and such," that's not scriptural. It's not found in the Bible. Choose to forgive. It's a choice. Don't rely on feelings. Feelings will come after obedience, always. Choose to forgive. "I choose to forgive such and such for pounding me in the face." Not, "Lord, help me to forgive." That is a prayer that is not scripturally rooted in truth. Therefore, it is powerless. So Luke 13, verse 11, "And behold, there was a woman which had a spirit of infirmity, 18 years, and was bowed together," or bowed together, "and could in no wise lift up herself. And when Jesus saw her, he called her to him and said unto her, Woman, thou art loosed from thine infirmity. And he laid his hands on her, and immediately she was made straight and glorified God." Everybody got upset that he was healing on the Sabbath. Verse 16, "And ought not this woman, being a daughter of Abraham, whom Satan hath bound, lo, these 18 years, be loosed from this bond on the Sabbath day?" Christians, yes, it is biblical that we heal the sick. In James, it talks about go get anointed by the elders, and their prayer of faith will forgive your sins, and you will be healed once they anoint you. There, yes, that's biblical. It is also biblical, just based on that one example. There's many more, but just based on that one example, Satan also causes diseases. So if you have prayed for healing and fasted, have cried out for God, and you still are sick, try the other part of the Bible. Seek deliverance. When I have a deliverance, I ask him every single physical issue that's going on in your life. And once you know it, every single physical issue, there's a demon that pops up and says, "Yep, I'm doing this. I'm doing that. I'm doing this. I'm doing that." When they're cast out, then healing is able to occur. I don't know what to tell you. Just try it. It's free. Just try it. It's free. So this is what deliverance is. I am your Christian brother. I am picking you up. You are filled with fiery darts. You're being lied to. You're bleeding. You're bruised. You're broken. I am picking you up. I'm using my shield, my sword, and I'm taking you back into the enemy's camp. And we're bringing back your health. We're taking back your mind. We're taking back your body. We're taking back your will. We're taking back your emotions. We're taking back your faith. We're taking back truth. That's what I'm doing for you. That is what deliverance is. There are demonic lies. Once a demon goes into you, they automatically start putting things against the door. They automatically start putting wood on the windows. They automatically start digging in into you. And what does that look like? It's demonic lies that keep them there. So a lot of times is that we're finding out the demonic lies that actually give them legal right, or that you believe that they should stay. Hence, you've been wounded and cursed and abused and diseased for decades because you believe, you deny that you have demons, which is a lie. You have pride, which God resists. You have a spirit of offense, which nobody can tell you the truth because there's a demon saying, oh, that guy is really, he's condemning. There's a spirit of condemnation where no matter what anybody says to you, whether it's in the Bible or anywhere, you automatically say, woe is me. And some of you like that. Some of you like saying, woe is me. Some of you like being the victim. That's a horrendous spirit to come against. They're very hard to get through to those people. I have spent hours upon hours upon hours loving and seeing God work in their life. And then 2 days later, they're writing me emails telling me I'm the devil. It just breaks my heart. The spirit of offense is one of the hardest things to break in somebody. I wish I can jump into your mind. I wish I can jump into your spirit and fight these demons off and make you choose faith and make you choose the truth, but I can't. What I can do is I can fast for you, lower my flesh, so I can hear the spirit on your behalf. And that's what I'm offering to you. All right? Joshua 7. Remember Achan? He saw some Babylonian gold and silver and he took it. And so I'm going to read to you what God says. So Israel goes up to attack Ai, who shouldn't be no problem whatsoever. But because Achan, who Joshua didn't even know about this sin happened, okay? Joshua did not know what Achan did, all right? But yet Achan's sin of taking a cursed item into the camp of Israel caused 36 men to die. That's a pretty brutal consequence. Verse 10, and the Lord said unto Joshua, get thee up, wherefore liest thou thus upon thy face? Joshua cried out, Joshua humbled himself. God responds to him. Okay, Joshua seeks the Lord, just like 2 Chronicles 7:14. I don't know where this attitude comes from, where we're not supposed to do any work. We're not supposed to cry out to the Lord and try to seek and be diligent. Go look up the word diligent. Type in zeal, type in diligence, strive, fervent. Yeah, we don't do these things for God's love or for his grace or mercy, but we dang well do them to be an approved servant of God. I don't know where this attitude comes from of just, we just lie back and we just got to tweak our mind just a little bit and realize that all this stuff is good and for my good. And then, you know, life's good. No, there's a battle, man. There's so many lies that's in us that we have to fervently, diligently fight against. Remember, we wrestle against the enemy. It's not just one prayer of out in the name of Jesus and all your dreams come true. And be not conformed to this world, but be transformed by the renewing of your mind, that ye may prove what is that good and acceptable and perfect will of God. This is another hindrance to deliverance. If you've served the devil your whole life and you make thousands of decisions for him, he has filled you with lies that go against God and holiness in the Bible. And so that's a huge part of deliverance, is just renouncing those lies, rejecting those lies, and speaking truth of the Word of God over ourselves. 2 Chronicles 7:14. If my people, which are called by my name, humble themselves, pray, seek my face, turn from their wicked ways, then I will hear them. Then I will forgive them. Then I will heal their lands. If then promise, guys, there's no way to get around it. If you humble yourself, God resists the proud. You want deliverance, but you think you have all the answers figured out? Have at it. Have at it. I've tried it your way. I've been in church for decades, going there 3 times a week, looking around, wondering, hey, where's the power? They have superior theology to me. They have superior doctrines. They know the exegesis and all this stuff. You know, fantastic. But you're dying of cancer. You have no hope. You have no joy. You have no peace. Sweet. Take your superior theology to the grave with you. Have at it. You have no fruit. In fact, you turn people away from God because you're arrogant, prideful, bitter, resentful, hurtful. But you have superior theology. Awesome. Have at it. I have no words to say for you. If the Holy Spirit did not bring you here saying that you have demons and that you are seeking freedom, What can I say? What can I say to prove it to you? If you humble yourself, if you pray, if you seek my face, if you turn from your wicked ways, then I will hear you. Then I will forgive you. Then I will heal your lands. Okay, so Achan. Did Joshua know before he went to battle with Achan, with Ai, that Achan took cursed items? No. 36 men died because of it. So Joshua humbles himself, seeks God, and is like, what's the deal? Verse 11, 7:11, Israel has sinned, and they have also transgressed my covenant, which I commanded them. For they have even taken of the accursed thing, and have also stolen and dissembled also, and they have put it even amongst their own stuff. Therefore, the children of Israel could not stand before their enemies, but turn their backs because their enemies, because they were accursed. Neither will I be with you anymore, except ye destroy the accursed from amongst you. Sanctify yourselves, basically find it out. Joshua goes and he seeks it out. God didn't say, hey, Achan has it, go kill him. He doesn't do that. Joshua had to go tribe by tribe, family by family, until he found Achan, had him destroyed, and then God was with him again. So that's what deliverance is. That's what I'm offering you. I am confronting the demons in you, okay? They are telling me, yeah, 5 years ago, they did this drug, or they lied, or they believed this lie that this demon told them, or that this demon manifested to them 5 years ago. They had fear, and now I'm in their life doing this, this, and this, and this in their life. Or the demon's like, I don't want to talk to you. I'm not going to say anything. Do you have a legal right? Yes. What is legal right? I'm not going to tell you. Okay, Holy Spirit revealed to us what this legal right is. 9 times out of 10, the Holy Spirit reveals it to us. We repent. We confess. We forgive that person that's giving this demon legal right. We do it. Demon, do you have legal right? Nope. Does that stand as truth before all should I? Yes. Clean up your mess. You know, what are you doing? How are you damaging the body? Clean up your mess. Cast them out. Simple. And then we move on. Okay. I have come across Christians that are strong Christians in the faith that have either had one demon all the way up until over 300 demons. And I'm sure the list is going to get bigger and bigger and bigger. We have so much disgusting evil things in our society. We have so many disgusting evil things that have been passed down by our ancestors directly to us that before we were even born, we've had this identity and this demon and this lie and this deception. And we don't even know what living righteously even looks like because we've just struggled and then we make a theology to justify our life. But yet you don't realize that you have a big demon that is inside you causing you to do this before you were even born. The Bible says, cast off every weight and run the race. If you are truly a Christian leader, you need to be leading by example, going, seeking deliverance and freedom. Even if you're clean bill of health, whatever, there are demons that are faith blockers. There are demons that are destiny destroyers. There are demons that even tempt you to vacuum your house more than once a day. Just even taking time away. You know, that's an exaggeration. But why even mess with it? Why even have it in your life when you don't have to? Yes, Jesus Christ, when he died on the cross, he said, it is finished. Meaning, he has given us all things in order to accomplish and come into our role to be the ambassador of Jesus Christ. He's given us the badge and he's given us the power. He's given us the gun. He's given us the authority. He's given us the power. If we don't use it, look around. That's what happens. When the church doesn't use their authority and the power, look around. That's what the current situation we're in right now. And all things are of God, who hath reconciled us to himself by Jesus Christ, and hath given to us the ministry of reconciliation. Given to us the ministry. To wit, that God was in Christ, reconciling the world unto himself, not imputing their trespasses unto them, and hath committed unto us the word of reconciliation. Now then, we are ambassadors for Christ, as though God did beseech you by us. We pray you in Christ's stead, be reconciled to God. For he hath made him to be sin for us, who knew no sin, that we might be made the righteousness of God in him. I'm going into the enemy's camp for you. I'm not asking for anything. I'm fasting for you. I'm spending hours with you, trying to get you free and seeing you be healed of your diseases, having instant fruit in your life, becoming more holier than you were before, able to attain the things of God that you struggled with your whole life. That's what I offer. What do I want in return? I want fruit to be in heaven waiting there for me. I want to see people there saying, because of you, I was able to do this and this and this and serve God. Therefore, thank you. That's what I want. I want, my eyes are on the prize. I want to produce fruit that produces fruit. And if you want to become a deliverance minister, I am here for you forever. I will give you help. I will bring you through it. I will train you. I'll deliver you. I will walk you through it. I will do whatever I can in my power to help you as a brother. That is my responsibility. That is my commitment. That is my job. That's my duty. I am to be diligent. I am to strive in that assignment. I know you guys think strive is a four-letter word. You're wrong. Look it up. Again, this is what deliverance is. You come, we seek the Lord together. I have you underneath my arm. I have my shield in front of you. I have my sword, and I'm also training you to go pick up your sword and go pick up your shield. Because there's a lot of lies that the demons have come in and they've barricaded themselves inside you as defense mechanisms, okay? And one of those defense mechanisms is offense. So if there's something that offends you, if somebody speaks the truth and goes to the Bible and it offends you, I highly recommend that you look past that offense and actually seek the Holy Spirit and saying, is this a word that I need to hear? Because offense is the number one thing, in my opinion, that the demon is able to twist you and turn you away from the truth, because it wants to stay in you. It wants to stay. It's comfy. It's been in your generations for 5, 6, 10 generations. It's been there for a long time. It wants to stay, and it's going to cause you to doubt any sort of deliverance because it is there to stay. Understand? So if you are offended, I highly encourage you, still take it before the Holy Spirit. Don't turn me off. Don't turn this off. Seek the Lord. Humble yourself. Is this true, God? Do I need deliverance? Do I have a demon? I've been a Christian for 30 years. I'm a pastor, blah, blah, blah. Yeah, I struggle with this. You know, my wife's dying of cancer. My kids are dying of, ADHD. Or, you know, us combined, we have 50 medications in the house. This is not the power of God. I'm pretty riled. Sorry. No, I'm not sorry. I'm a warrior of God. I want you out of hell. I'm not sorry. Forget I said that. Get offended. Die in your offense. You are dying in your offense. You want a superior theology than me? Die in the grave with that superior theology. I have done it your way. I have been in churches for decades. Looked around. Hey, no power of God. Hey, where's the power of God? I finally found it. Jesus Christ says himself that casting out demons is a miracle. And John answered him, saying, Master, we saw one casting out devils in thy name, and he followeth not us. And we forbade him, because he followeth not us. But Jesus said, Forbid him not, for there is no man which shall do a miracle in my name that can lightly speak evil of me. For he that is not against us is on our part. So if you've asked for a miracle ministry, and the Holy Spirit has sent you here to this channel, guess what? He's answering your prayers. And if you've been delivered, but you can't tell your friends and family that you had demons, you are a coward. You are taking the talent that God has paid for on the cross. He bared the shame. He was spit upon. He was beat to destroy the works of the devil. You have been delivered of the devil because of what Jesus Christ did for you, but you are so afraid of being ridiculed and mocked. And so you go up in the backyard, wrap your talent in a napkin, and bury it. The Bible calls you a wicked servant. I want to invest in fruit that produces fruit. Look at Jesus Christ. He was the best multi-level marketer out there. Yes, he preached to the multitudes, but he also poured his life into 12 people. And out of that 12, he poured his life into 3 people. And you're going to say, oh, it's offense that I don't have this healing because of my faith or my lack of faith. Take it up with the Word of God. How many times did the disciples cry out to Jesus for help? And Jesus said, man, how long do I have to strive with you guys? You guys are kind of bumming me out. How long do I have to put up with you guys? For calling on me when I've given you the power, I've given you the keys of the kingdom, I've given you all things that you need, but yet you still cry out to me. Don't believe me? Go watch my Survival 101, Faith or Flood. When the boat was rocking, where was Jesus? He was asleep. They cried out to Jesus to save him. What did he say? Was he happy? Oh, thanks guys for relying on me. Thank you for calling out to me in times of trouble. No, you have little faith. Yeah, great. Peter walked out of the boat and was walking on the water, but he started sinking. He cried out to Jesus, which we're all taught. That's what we should do, just cry out to Jesus. Well, Jesus is saying, you have little faith. You had the power to walk on the water based on your faith, but you gave it up. You started looking at your circumstances. You started looking at the devil. You started looking at the world system. You started looking at your experiences. You started looking at other people that have nothing to do with you. And you're like, well, they died of cancer and they had tremendous faith. Really? Is that person going to stand with you when you are judged? Is that person going to be like, hey, man, you know, I died of cancer. They knew me. You know, come on, God, let them off. No, you will be judged based on the word of God, based on truth, based on what the Holy Spirit has showed you. This right here, this truth is way up here. We always need to strive, be diligent to attain it of what it says. Not make some theology where I can put it below my feet and stand on it. I always need to strive because my life doesn't look like this. So there's something wrong. It sure ain't this. It sure ain't this. Another thing about diseases and sicknesses, in my first video, in the first video of the series, I made the mistake of saying, you know, the disciples went out two by two. Jesus Christ sent out the 70. He didn't say, you know, stop and ask them, hey, am I using this sickness in their life, you know, to teach them a lesson? Okay, I need to tweak that a little bit. I forgot a huge point. If there's cities that denied them entry and didn't honor them as servants of God, the Bible said those cities, it would be more easier in the judgment on Sodom than it would be for those cities. So I need to make that point clear. So the disciples who went and did heal and did do the miracles, their cities already opened their doors to them and said, we receive you as men and women of God. Okay? Another point, 2 Samuel 6, Michael, you guys know the story. She looks down from the window. David's dancing in his underwear because he's so excited that the Ark of the Covenant is coming back to Israel. She looks at him in verse 16, and she despised him in her heart. Okay, verse 20. Then David returned to bless his household, and Michael, the daughter of Saul, came out to meet David and said, how glorious was the king of Israel today, who uncovered himself today in the eyes of the handmaids of his servants as one of the vain fellows shamelessly uncovereth himself. It's basically mocking him. Verse 23, what happens to Michael? Therefore, Michael, the daughter of Saul, had no child unto the day of her death. Okay? Michael despises David in her heart. She's barren for the rest of her life. Okay, let's just surmise, okay? In my experience, this happens all the time. That's what deliverance is. That's what I'm offering to you. I seek the Holy Spirit on your behalf. You seek the Holy Spirit. I confront the demons in you, and they say, yes, 20 years ago, this person despised David in their heart. Do you have a legal right to be here? Yes. What are you doing physically to Michael? I'm causing barrenness. Now, is it possible that God just made her barren and there was no demons involved? Yeah, totally possible. But in my experience, it's because of your sin, your rebellion, your believing lies, on and on, generational curses that were passed down to you from your parents. Oh, there's a history of alcoholism in my family. Oh, there's a history of cancer in my family. There's a history of this. Okay, I accept it. It's mine. Da-da-da. I die. Based on that, demons are in your life. Do you have a legal right? Yes, you despise King David. Hey, Michael, do you want to humble yourself and ask for forgiveness for despising King David in your heart? Yes. Father God, please forgive me. I was wrong. King David is your anointed one. He was dancing before you. Please forgive me. I have sinned. Lord, please forgive me. Demon of barrenness, come back up. Do you have a legal right? No. Clean up your mess. Leave. Guess what? Michael's not barren any longer. I don't know what to tell you. Those are the facts. Those are the facts. Just like Paul, how he said, hey man, I don't ask nothing from you all. So that should be a sign that I'm from God. You don't know my name unless I'm talking to you privately in emails. You don't know the name of my ministries. It's not a my name ministries, that's for sure. I don't ask for money. I'm the one that is fasting for you, which is difficult. It's not fun. I'm the one spending anywhere between 4 hours to 10 hours to 20 hours fighting your demons for you. I'm the one that before the deliverance session happens, my dog is urinating, acting the fool. I get in fights before the deliverance because Satan wants to show me how much of a... He wants to attack me, so I will cancel the deliverance session. And for you deliverance ministers out there, you need to expect that. And thank God it's not a my name ministries. This thing is God's. This ministry is God's. The power to deliver people is through the Holy Spirit. It's not mine. Thank God for it. Because my best deliverances is when I feel like garbage. My best deliverances that I see the power of God manifest, cast out these demons who have been there for generations, and they're weeping and they're crying because the power of God has hit them upside the head. They have no choice but to leave, stripped, naked, going into hell, going into torment, going wherever Jesus Christ sends them. The best times that I've seen that happen is when I, Archangel, feels like a piece of dirt. Because 5 minutes before, my dog was urinating all over our brand new carpet. I lose my temper. Yeah, that's the honest truth of it. I am nobody. Except I know who I am in Jesus Christ. Jesus Christ has given us all things to defeat the enemy. All things. And if you have cried out for God to heal your sickness, your disease, your torment, your depressions, you're going to pharmaceuticals, you're getting worse off than you were before, stop the negative cycle, you're killing yourself, you're killing your family, you're being a horrible example for the kingdom of God, you're screaming, where is the power of God? And I'm saying, hey, I found a piece of it. I give it to you freely. And you want to argue theology with me, you want to deny it, you want to be prideful, you want to turn your back and say you're full of crap, that's fine. The only people you're hurting is the kingdom of God. Look around you, this army that's going into the camp of hell, it's not very big. It's not very big at all. I want to honor somebody, Angel and Annette. They drove up from L.A., 6.5 hours, should have taken them 8 hours. Hopefully I delivered them of a speed demon. They got delivered. Son started his deliverance. They finished it back home. They went back home, and within like the first week of them being delivered, they were like delivering three people. I mean, these guys took what Jesus Christ gave them, automatically start flipping it and pushing it out. I want to honor them. I also want to thank my partner, Johnny. He's been a great support, great encourager. When he found out that the Lord was leading me down this road of deliverance, he was, yeah, let's do it. And he was delivered without even, teaching him what's going on. The Holy Spirit confirmed it in him. He said, let's do it. And he got delivered and is still showing lasting results from that. I want to thank my wife. She's a great support. Allowed me to practice on her before I was even delivered. So these are honorable people, and I want to continue on. I want to produce warriors. And this is my commitment to you. I want to have 100 people that I train or I help get into the ministry of deliverance and have them start doing deliverances. That's my goal. I don't want to reach 1 million people. I don't want to just to give you a message and just have it skip off you, you know, have you just dent you a little bit. Oh yeah, praise, you know, Brother Archangel, thank you. That was a great message. You've taught me something that lasted 24 hours. I was encouraged. Thank you. Thank you, brother. Forget that. I want fruit that produces fruit. I want lasting results. I'm into fruit. I'm into results. Okay? You know, granted, the Holy Spirit has given me lessons to teach you. I'm not negating that. I'm not negating that because a lot of those, you know, the truth of the Word of God comes and it actually comes against the demonic lies that actually allows the enemy to infiltrate your life. A lot of people don't even believe that God can even heal you. A lot of people believe that it's God who given you the disease. And so, you know, heck, I'm going to die with it. God gave it to me. That means he wants me to have it forever. So I'm going to die peacefully in my bed, not helping anybody else. That's a demonic lie. But listen to me. If you rebel against God, God steps back. It's really powerful. I'm going to read that again. I'm going to read this again. Very powerful. God just showed this to me. Joshua 7:12. Therefore, the children of Israel, my people, my chosen people, the children of Israel, could not stand before their enemies, could not stand before their demons, but turned their backs before their enemies. They were defeated by the devils because they were accursed. Neither will I be with you anymore, except ye destroy the accursed from amongst you. That's what deliverance is, guys. We seek the Holy Spirit. Why is there sickness and disease in your life? Why is your finances cursed? Why is your health cursed? Why is your relationships cursed? Why is your faith cursed? Why are you fruitless? Why are you dead? Why are you dying? Why are you depressed? Why are you struggling? Okay? Why? That's what I'm offering to you. We seek God together. I confront the demons because I'm the ambassador of Jesus Christ. These demons come forward and say, yes, I went to Babylon. I saw some silver and gold. I took it, even though I knew it was wrong. This was 20 years ago. It's underneath my bed. That's the root of my power. And I'm doing this, this, and this, and this in their life. I'm destroying their relationships. He has cancer in the legs. He has heart issues. He has high blood pressure. He has diabetes. He has this. He has this. He has this. And it's because of that stuff underneath his bed. Okay, I bring you back up. Hey, do you want to go take care of that stuff underneath the bed? Do you want to get rid of that cursed items? No. Okay, deliverance is over. Have fun with your diseases. You wasted my time. But I've never had anybody do that. Yes, I want to take care of it. I'm going to go take care of it right now. Okay, they take care of it. Hey, demon, do you have legal right now? Nope. Okay, clean up your mess. Fix the cancer. Fix the relationships. Fix all this stuff that you've been messing up. Have you fixed your damage? Yes or no? Yes. Does that stand as truth before El Shaddai? Yes. I bind you as one kingdom. Look to Jesus Christ. Where is he sending you? He's sending me here. Okay? I cast you and your kingdom out into the abyss or wherever Jesus Christ sends them. Okay? It's pretty simple. Pretty simple. The deliverance can take anywhere between 2 hours to 6.5 hours, depending on how ready your heart is, how many demons you have, to be honest with you, there's some times that the Holy Spirit doesn't answer me what the reason why that demon's there, and the demon doesn't answer me what the reason that demon's there. It's taken me 3 hours to try to get rid of one demon before. And to me, I don't know why that happens. I have one theory, which is sometimes people's relationship with God is so fragile, so weak, so minuscule, so rooted in lies because they've served the devil most of their life that we need to go baby steps. Because if God reveals anything big to them, it could crush them. That's one reason. Another reason is that there's freedom. Every single deliverance, there's something that's got done. God has showed up some way, somehow. Even if you forgive one person, that's a successful deliverance, in my opinion. I did not finish my thought. Every deliverance, God moves on their behalf some way, somehow. Sometimes it is not complete, but the client still needs to go home and praise Jesus and be thankful for what was done. Continue to seek the Holy Spirit as to why the demons were allowed to stay. Be thankful. Don't go into victim mode. We will fight later when the Holy Spirit reveals the hinge pin. God cares about the heart. Does God care that Michael was barren? No, God cares that she despised King David in her heart. So if Michael submitted herself, humbled herself, repented of despising King David, I believe that she would be able to have kids. But here's the thing too. A lot of people repent of their sins, but they never cast out the demon. You don't know how many times I've been in deliverance and none of the demons had legal rights. Like they had over 200 demons. None of them had legal rights. None. Not one. They were good. They forgave quickly. They sought the Lord. They humbled themselves. They confessed. But every single demon was a squatter. Every single one. They're still active. Still were destroying things. Still were making a wreck in their life. But not one of them had a legal right. We're just not taught we can cast them out. We're not taught that we're supposed to go into hell and the hell's gates can't prevail against us. So, go through the deliverance series. Seek a deliverance minister in your own area, okay? I just believe that God wants a local body, a unified body. I believe that's the way he designed it. But listen to me. This is my commitment to you. If you do not find a deliverance minister in your area, or if you get the EBGBs, or hopefully the EBGBs from the Holy Spirit, not a false Holy Spirit or your demons are saying, yeah, I don't like this guy because he's going to cast me out. So, I don't know what to tell you on that one. But they just, either they brush you off or they don't do a complete deliverance. You feel like they've gotten rid of a couple, but you got a lot more. If that stuff happens, come back here. I will help you. We will do a deliverance over Skype, okay? Use me. I am your final, you know. I will fight with you. I get bruised with you. I'm in war with you. Woe is the man who doesn't have a brother to pick him up, right? Where two or three or more are gathered. There's some promises that I'm offering you that are biblical, all right? God love you. I love you. I want fruit that produces fruit. I want to see people get delivered. If you've been given a gift and you bury it, woe is you. God bless. El Shaddai bless.